Welcome to Art Scene. We're in Greenpoint, Brooklyn, not only a great place to gaze at the Manhattan skyline, but it's also a great place to explore art. In this episode, we're headed to Steve Wasterval's studio to see his urban-inspired paintings. Let's go.
Hey, how's it going?
Good to see you.
Come on in.
Thank you so much for having us. This is a blast. I've been wanting to come to your studio for a while, so I'm psyched to be here. What's it like working in Greenpoint?
I love it. It's an artist community. It's really inspiring, and it's a lot of fun, too.
Are there any people in your life that inspire you?
Well, Don Sally is who taught me how to paint landscape. He was taught in Russian Impressionist style by Sergei Bongard, and I loved that because it was like aggressive impressionism. It wasn't pretty, it had really sharp edges, and it had that grit and a lot of palette knife scraping and that stuff. So I really loved that.
Tell me a little bit about where all this energy and inspiration comes from.
It's New York energy, and New York's my biggest inspiration right now. Like I said, landscapes are my first passion, and so naturally when I moved to New York, I was painting cityscapes, because there's no trees and no water, so it was all buildings. And then the buildings were covered with other people's art and old ads and things like that. The most inspiring part about the New York landscape is how colorful it is and how gritty it is and how collaborative it is. And so my work is like appropriating all of these other graffiti artists and street artists' work into my kind of like impressionist landscapes of those scenes.
What is your process like, and what media do you use?
I call it mixed media, but it's really just a collection of all the things that I have: markers, pastels, paint, pencil, charcoal. So I'm always taking photos and collecting good photos of New York and street art, and then I just try to have them available. And then that's what the painting ends up being, is a collage of these different moments.
When I first walked in, I noticed you started working on a new piece that's very identifiable as, a landscape in a New York City scene. What's the inspiration for this piece?
What you can see right now is like the representational part of it that I'm going to be doing down the center. And I want to have all that light that you're talking about and all that New York vibrance kind of like bursting out of the center of the painting. And then kind of frame it with the other stuff we're talking about, like the street art and the more abstract stuff. That's the beginning of the street art and graffiti kind of creeping into the landscapes.
Right.
Like you can see that the rest of it is definitely stylized. This is an early one where I started to merge the two. This one's also named by the location. I think it's North 7th and Bedford.
These are actual pieces that were done on walls that you're then recreating into this piece. Do you ever get in touch with any of these artists?
I do. And the way I find out is on Twitter and on Facebook. And so I just have to hunt for these guys. So I email them the paintings when they're finished, and they're always happy to see them. And I'm sending it to them also to show them how great I think their art is. It's just like another landscape I would paint. I mean, I paint it because
right?
It's beautiful. And it's the same thing with this.
If each of your paintings is created based on a place, where are we now?
We are on Bedford again.
What are some of the recognizable imagery in this piece?
This one, the recognizable imagery would be the ads, because it's mostly ads and also local posters and flyers. So that's all part of the familiarity that I'm going for when I paint these scenes, that you're going to recognize where it was. And even if you don't right away, if you look at it closely, you might see these details that remind you of like your corner or your neighborhood.
So it's like this familiar unfamiliarity. It's encouraging people to engage with things they've seen around them in an entirely different way.
That's a great way to say it, actually. The unfamiliar and the familiar.
So much for having us by your studio. This is an absolute blast. I loved exploring New York through your eyes and through your artwork.
Pleasure was all mine. Thanks for coming.
Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next time on Art Scene.